As you're speaking about protest atheism, I think often about your concept of protest hope, that for us as people of God in the world, that we live not necessarily as protest atheists, but as protesting hope. You know, we are the people who hold on to the hope in the face of the suffering of reality. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Well, what is the art of hope? According to the second letter of Peter, chapter 3:13 or something like that, we should wait and hasten to the future of the coming day of the Lord. To wait and to hasten looks like contradictory, but is not. To wait doesn't mean to wait on Godot, but to expect somebody who promised his coming, and you know already the name, and you feel the approach. To wait is not to adjust to unjust conditions in the present, because you know that it can be changed and will be changed, and therefore you resist conformity and silence to injustice and violence in your surrounding. So to wait in this sense means to resist. I think it's in Isaiah 26, where the people in the Babylonian exile say, yes, there are other lords who have dominion over us, but we remember only you and thy name. This is to wait, to expect and to resist. And to hasten it means to run from one place to another in space. But what does hasten mean in time to the coming day of the Lord? It means to anticipate, to transcend the limitations of reality into the realm of possibility, to anticipate the earth on which righteousness will dwell, and every piece of righteousness we can do here and now is an anticipation of that righteousness which will form the new earth or an everlasting earth. So I interpret to wait and to hasten at this point, to resist and to anticipate.
How do we do that as a church collectively? How do we actively resist injustice, I guess, in the world? How do we actively as a church body resist that and be in dialogue and resistance, I guess, with the powers that be?
Well, follow the Sermon on the Mount.
Duh.
You must be more specific. I think one point in this country would be to resist capital punishment, because this is not according to the righteousness of God. But then you will come into a very into a struggle with more conservative people who believe that this is in the name of God. But after the capital punishment Jesus suffered, there can be, from my understanding, no justification for capital punishment, which is a violence in the name of the state and is creating new violence. And so there are concrete points where you can engage. Yeah. I must not show more about it. In all the churches we pray, but the New Testament call is not only to pray, but pray and watch. So open your eyes if you pray to God and see what is in contradiction to God and what is in analogy to the coming of God. Watch and don't close your eyes and transcend into the other world. Praying with open eyes.